Hey, hi everybody. I hope you're all having a good day. I hope you're all smiling and enjoying your lovely day. So in this following tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you on how to set up your character settings inside of Warudo. Now, of course, there are a lot of settings to go through, but I'll try my best to summarize them as best as I can, because there is a lot to go through, basically. But pretty much, in case you don't know, Warudo is a brand new VTuber program. You could do a lot of crazy stuff. You can be pretty simple with Warudo if you wish. But otherwise, if you want to be super insane with Warudo, such as doing coding stuff and all that, then Warudo allows you to do that. It's a really intense program. You can definitely check it out. But either way, though, I'm going to go ahead here. Pretty much, Warudo will have its editor, and then there'll be the Warudo screen here, as you can see. And in my previous tutorial, we went over the onboarding assistant. So if you are very brand new to Warudo, I highly recommend please check out that tutorial or go ahead and click on these buttons. It should already have a tutorial built into it pretty much in case you don't know how to set up your tracking and all that. But either way, here we are on the Warudo character settings. So we're going to go ahead and go through each of these settings to show you an overview of it. There are going to be some settings that are like more in-depth. So let's say with the motion capture, there's a lot more that goes into motion capture stuff, depending on the solution you're choosing though. But primarily for this tutorial, we're only going to be focusing on whatever is provided here. The rest will be either its own tutorial or will be explained somewhere else basically. But either way, to start off, enabled. In case you don't know what that is, it's basically where you can enable or disable your character. This is pretty much useful if you have different characters that you want to toggle in Warudo. Definitely very useful. But for my case, I want to keep mine enabled. Here in the transform view, you can actually be able to change the position of your character, basically. Change the rotation. This is pretty useful for like corrections or if you want your character to be in a specific place for an environment. This is definitely useful to mess with. And also, you can do it very precisely and put exact values. So you can do that. Or you can just click and drag here to just change it, basically. So yeah. But either way, the next thing is, of course, making sure your avatar is loaded here. Now, in case you don't know how to set this up pretty much, you basically, in order to load your avatar here, you just click on the Open Characters folder here. And then right here, you can copy and paste your VRM file into this folder right here. There's also the Warudo file format, which is basically like VSF avatar for VC face, but Warudo pretty much allows you to have a very insane characters with custom shaders, custom animation, because VRM does not allow that stuff, because VRM is a universal file. Warudo is an asset bundle just like VSF avatar. And in case you're wondering, no, Warudo does not support VSF avatar files, because VSF avatar is a VC face file format. Vignon supports it, of course, but the reason why Warudo doesn't have it is because Warudo has 500 plus animations and it'll conflict with the VSF avatar file format. So that's why there's no VSF avatar in Warudo. So instead they have their own file format that's similar to VC face, but it works with Warudo. So I highly recommend check out the Warudo SDK, link in description for some information on that. But either way, if you have a lot of avatars, of course, you can go ahead and click on preview gallery and you can go through which character you want. Otherwise, though, you could be able to paste your VRM file in the characters folder, and you should be able to load your avatar here. It should automatically update. No need to restart Warudo. Once you load your avatar in here, what you're going to then do is set up your motion capture here. So you can click on set up motion capture right here, or you can remove it if you set up yours on the onboarding assistant. And basically right here on face tracking template, this is referring to what type of face tracking style do you want. For OpenSea face, this is highly recommended for beginners, for people who don't know what air kit blend shapes are, who's very brand new to VTubing overall. If you have a webcam on you, this is definitely highly recommended. If by any chance you don't have a webcam and you don't have iPhone, there are other solutions such as VTube Studio Android and Meow Face, but that kind of goes into a little bit slightly complex area with VMC, which we'll go over that in a little bit. Well, we won't be going over how to set up the Android solutions, though, but hopefully in the future, Warudo may integrate, something like VTube Studio in or something, I don't know, some sort of Android stuff, who knows. But either way, if you are brand new to VTubing and you want to at least start off simple, OpenSea face is definitely great to start off with. If you know what air kit blend shapes are and you know that your model has air kit blend shapes and you don't have an iPhone, you can use MediaPipe. Do keep in mind the tracking may be a little bit derpish at first, but there are settings you can use so you can adjust the blend shapes so it can look really good. It's going to be a lot of tinkering though, a lot of settings. But there's that option for media pipe if you have air kit blanchet. But otherwise, there is the option with Warudo, thankfully. If you click on this, you can set it up to work with VRM. So it's, again, pretty much just out of preference. I would just say experiment, mess around with the settings, because this is going to require a lot of experimenting and personal preference stuff, basically. But there's that as the option. If you, by any chance, have air kit blanchets and you do... you do by any chance have iFacial mocap or face motion 3D. Face motion 3D will work as long as you set up iFacial mocap. You can have that. And of course, again, the beauty of Warudo is that you can map it to VRM or MMD blend shapes even, basically, with, you know, the one standard blend shapes that Anamaza and Tita Miku uses. Pretty much that's standard. So yeah. But anyway, that's at least the beauty of Warudo. You can choose whichever blend shape mapping you want, depending on the tracking solution you prefer. But again, though, each and every one of them, they do have their own sort of quality, so it's just a matter of experimenting. Real Live, in case you don't know what that is, it's Real Live is an app that's only on the Apple Store. You can download it and you can use it. So not only do you have AirKit face tracking, but you can also have hand tracking from your phone. It's pretty nice for people who don't have a Leap Motion or they have webcam, but they don't like it. But even then, the hand tracking on Real Live is still very derpy. It's a lot more derpier than MediaPipe, though, but again, you may prefer it more. Depends on you, basically. But there's that one. The app is not in English, though, so keep that in mind. But otherwise, the Warudo documentation does have an English translation, so you can definitely check that out. VMC, again, if you have webcam motion capture, XR anime for full body webcam tracking, or maybe you have an Android solution like Meow Face that you want to put into Warudo, you can use, of course, Face Mocap to VMC for that. So external programs that, you know, that are not natively supporting Warudo, you can have them set up in Warudo with VMC, basically. And also fun fact too, with I believe MediaPipe or OpenSeaFace, you could set up Droid Cam, so you can have like you know, sort of webcam tracking, but with your phone, by the way, just a little fun fact. But otherwise, though, like I said, you're going to have to do a lot of experimenting and researching, depending on the solution you want. There's a lot to go through. Then you have Rococo Face Capture, which I don't really recommend for VTuber. It's more for corporate, like, I wouldn't say the companies, corporations, I guess. Basically, more high-end indie studios or something like that. Basically, they would use Rococo. If they have the Rococo Face Capture subscription, they can, of course, use Rococo. Preference, of course. But otherwise, if Rococo is too expensive, then just use iFacial mocap or the others. There's also Verdant Studio, which if you have the Verdant mocap gear, they do have their own face capture app with their mocap suits. Again, same thing with Rococo, they have it for their mocap suits and Verdant with theirs. Same quality, basically. So there really isn't much different with the face tracking, but again, it's preference. But either way, though, I'm going to choose iFacial mocap for mine. I'm going to choose ARKit. I will make sure that the head and body movements are enabled. If you're using full body tracking like VR, Mocopy, Sign VR, or mocap suit, then please make sure you have this set to no. Otherwise, if you want to have that body movements, then please select yes. You can have the idle head animation only when it's not tracking. I would prefer this, but if you don't want it, like, you see how, like, my character is moving on the side, basically? That's basically the idle head animation going on. But otherwise, if you don't want that, you could disable it or you can have it always enabled, but I would just leave the default. Look at is enabled when tracking, so if your character your camera is moving around, your character's head will follow, so you can have this set up, basically. Lip sync is definitely really nice if by any chance, let's say you feel like your face tracking is very much lacking or you just prefer lip sync at preference, you could definitely have it always enabled. For my case, because I'm using iFacial mocap and I know my blend shape work well, I'm going to keep it disabled, but otherwise you can have it enabled if you wish. But either way, we're going to click on OK. Pose tracking is referring to your body, so MediaPipe, you can have webcam hand tracking. Real Live, if you want to have the hand tracking from your phone, there's that if you don't have a Leap Motion. VMC, for this case, if you have a Leap Motion, the reason why Leap Motion is not native in Warudo is because of MediaPipe, because with the right settings with MediaPipe, you could actually get pretty much better tracking, quote-unquote. Again, I personally prefer Leap Motion, but for other people, they had a better experience with media pipe hand tracking, especially with Warudo settings. If you tinker with them a lot, you can get some really good tracking quality, basically. So if you really prefer leap motion, maybe because you have a very small space, then you're going to have to use VC Face and use VMC to do that instead. But who knows, maybe in the future they might add leap motion. Otherwise, no, you're just going to have to use media pipe. If you have a mocap suit from Rococo, you can use Rococo. If you have an XM mocap suit, you can do that. Or if you have the Verdant Studio mocap suit, then you can also use that. For this case, we're going to use media pipe hand tracking. And for this one, in case you're wondering, this is, in case you ever heard of the program VMagic Mirror or VDraw, you can be able to have these options where you can have a keyboard or a trackpad, especially if you're an artist or if you just like to have like a sort of gaming sort of setup with a keyboard, then there is that basically. For my case, I'm going to have mine set to DroidCam. Now, mine actually is Elgato, but because there's like a weird face a camera ID issue I'm having for some reason, I have to leave it as its default, otherwise it won't work for me, but it may be different for you. I'm just saying, in the time of recording of this video, I do have a camera ID issue. But either way, I'm going to click on OK. And as you can see, it's set up. I can click on OK. Do excuse that there is an error here. Again, I'm having some camera issues. I believe that that error was because of Elgato being really derpish, but either way, as you can see, I have my face tracking, and also in case you're wondering, it's middle mouse in order to move your character around, scroll wheel to zoom in and out, right click to rotate, and then of course left click, same thing basically, just the default settings. So yeah, and as you can see, I am tracking, so pretty much you can click on the keyboard also, and you can just click and drag if your keyboard is a bit too high or too weird, basically, so you can adjust here. Same thing with trackpad, just click here and then find the arrows and then just go from here. So there you go. So we can do some adjustments. There you go. And then pretty much, if you don't want it on, you can click on the no here. Just wanted to quickly show you that. As for iFacial mocap, you could definitely mess with your settings, of course, here. Again, everyone's different regarding their settings. I cannot really show you what's the perfect settings, because again, everybody has different preference. I cannot make the settings for you. But basically, though, you can adjust the settings here. I can go ahead and increase my movement range and then increase this more, so that way I have a bit more movement, so I'm not as stiff. So pretty much I could do that. So yeah, I'm just gonna mainly play around with these settings. Basically, I really don't want to make this tutorial too long though, but pretty much you can just mess with the settings here, and I'm gonna go ahead and like have a little bit of an offset for my head here like that. And then I can also click on calibrate, so that way I'm like recentered basically. You can also configure blend shape mapping here, so kind of like VTuber Studio basically. If you ever use VTuber Studio before, it's pretty much like the same setup. Otherwise, if you never use VTuber Studio, pretty much primarily you'll be messing with the input values basically. So if you want to like change certain things, you can make it so like, you know, something can move more or move less. It depends on your settings. But primarily, again, it's like, you'll have to mess around with these. I cannot properly explain these, sadly. Primarily, I would mess with the input, because that's what, like, what's going, you know, what's being input and output. It's like, pretty much like the end result, basically, if that makes sense. But for the most part, for at least my case with iFacial mocap or Face Motion 3D, I just edit the blend shape within the app. But otherwise, you can mess with these things. Just play around with it, experiment, depending on what you want. But yeah. But either way, there's also eye movement intensity, which mine doesn't move that much. So I'll slightly increase mine here. There you go. Actually, I'll change mine from eye bones to blend shapes. So Sorry again for going like all over the place regarding the whole thing. So, like I said, I really don't want to make this too long of a tutorial. But again, just messing around with the settings. You can see how like I'm playing with the settings basically. There's also like a little compensation, which the compensation is referring to if I rotate my head and such, basically. So yeah. I believe we don't have to calibrate eye movement and such. I believe there is, yeah, so there's that. All right, so pretty much you can mess with the settings. I will limit the eye squint, I believe. do I want to limit it? Nah, I wouldn't. So, pretty much these are, like, I guess my settings here, basically. Head movement, all that. So just play around with the settings however you like. And then as for media pipe tracker, this is referring to the hand tracking. So pretty much you can, of course, you can see the tracking right here. Hello, hello, hello. Just make sure that your tracking's right there. And then you can pretty much go through here, mess with the settings. I can set this to real time, I guess. Nah, I think I would prefer high. And then, of course, you can mirror tracking, which I think not. Yeah, we'll have it like this. So face tracking is disabled. So we'll have it so that way. Yeah, so we don't have the face tracking from media pipe, so we don't have to worry about the face tracking here. But pretty much, I will say, if you are using webcam tracking, it's pretty much the same settings as I had with iFacial mocap here. You could just play around with the settings pretty much for the most part. So yeah, you can change your head movement stuff, change your intensity, all that. For hand tracking, the settings are a bit different though. So for calibrate hand tracking, it's pretty much the same, where you're gonna have to have your hand in the air, and then it'll tell you right here. So it says make sure at a comfortable distance, raise one hand, and then right next to the ear, press yes, and there you go, my hand is calibrated. You can also invert hands, but I won't do that. That's also if you just want to swap it, basically. So I can, of course, increase the movement range of my hands if I wish. If I want to have, like, more movement, I can make it so that way I can do this. So that way there's a lot more movement going on, basically. So you don't want, if you don't want to be too stiff, you could just increase. Try not to do it too much, because then it's going to look really awkward. But you can do that. Wow! You can also do offset in case the hands are like too low or anything like that. So yeah, for my case, I can be able to move my hands in the air. So yeah, so we can do that. Horizontal distance compensation, that's if, this is regarding, like, if by any chance you want your hands to be closer. Don't make this too high of a setting, but otherwise, because it is going to cause some drifting issues, basically. For my case, my webcam setup is really ridiculous, sadly, because again, I have a really bad position for my webcam. But otherwise, though, this can help get your hands to be more closer together, basically. Which again, I have a bad position for my webcam because I have an iPhone. Then there is a hand wide threshold. If, let's say, there are hands in the distance, like from other people or a picture or something, you can increase this a bit more to kind of help, you know, make the tracking, like, not super sensitive, basically. And then as for camera diagonal field of view, if you know your camera specification, which you can look up on your manufacturer's website. For my case, I have an Elgato camera, so I just have to look up Elgato camera field of view settings, and it will pop up on the website. But for your case, you may have to look up a different manufacturer for your case. You don't have to change the setting, but it does help you if you want better accuracy, basically, of field of view, basically. You know, mainly for range. I think mine was about, like, 80 or 81, though, but I'm not going to change it for now in case it's wrong. But yeah, but either way though, there's camera aspect ratio. Mine's a full HD camera, so I don't have to touch it, but if your camera is low res, you may want to change the ratio, but you should be fine. And then you have the push settings here. This is basically, like, if your hands are clipping too much to your body, you may want to increase the push values here, Z and Y, to ensure that your hands are not clipping as much to your body, basically. But for the most part, it should be fine depending on how you set up your other settings. But yeah, and then pretty much there is offset here. This is referring to, like, if your hands are up in the air and you have your shoulders and such, you can pretty much just adjust that, basically. Again, you know, mess around with settings, basically. I'll put mine to a lower value, but yeah, actually I'll put mine to be this one, actually. So yeah, and then, of course, hand calibration distance. This one, when you calibrate your hands, basically, it's going to give you those values. So that's pretty much, you don't touch those. You can reset it, of course, but otherwise you don't touch those because that's your calibration setup. Then you have, of course, shoulder correction. I usually leave that as yes. Finger rotation. If you have weird fingers, like your thumb is going backwards or something, you can use these settings to adjust your thumb so they're more accurate. There are the lot of settings, of course, but you could pretty much just, you know, do this basically. And then, of course, I can make the fingers even more accurate by adjusting the bend of the fingers, basically. So I can adjust this. I can have it where if my hands are slightly here, I can have it so they can bend backwards. Because hands slightly do bend backwards, so there's that. And then, of course, I can change the bone intensity for the rotation here. Which I'll leave mine, like, in the middle. So, yeah. So there you go. And then, of course, you can limit your rotations, basically. This is so that way your hands don't look super derpy. So it's recommended that you keep it on. Otherwise, if you feel like it's, like, if you feel like, again, you can see how my hand looks a little derpish, but with the rotation limit, it makes it more natural. So I recommend keeping that on, basically. I'm going to go ahead also up here, and I'm going to go ahead and... Not that one. Hand tracking up here. I'm gonna reduce the value. It's too high. Yeah, so like about here, basically. But pretty much, what I was just showing you, at least, is just showing you, like, how you can, like, mess with the settings. Again, everyone is different on how they want their settings, basically. But hopefully, just you watching me setting up my tracking solution could hopefully help you out on, like, understanding, like, how I personally set my tracking. So that way, it can sort of, like, give you sort of, like, a guidance, basically. So, yeah. I know I said I wouldn't cover anything else, like, extra from here, but this is still count, so yeah. But either way, though, you can pretty much, that's pretty much in a nutshell regarding the whole, like, mocap capture setup, at least for, like, the body tracking thing, you know, for, at least for my case, it's iPhone, but for your case, the information I showed here, or at least, like, I kind of, like, glance over, should also apply, basically, so yeah. But either way, though, you know, adjust how you want. Mess with the settings. There's a lot of experimenting with Warudo, basically, so, yeah. But either way, you can, of course, calibrate iFusion mocap if you wish, in case your tracking goes a little derpish, or you can calibrate your hand tracking if you wish, and of course, again, depending on the tracking solution, that you prefer, you know, the settings should be there. You just click on, depending on the setting that you want, and bada bing, bada boom. And of course, there is, of course, a blueprint navigation here. So, like, let's say if you want to fine-tune your settings even more, you can just click right here, and it will teleport you to the node that pretty much is responsible for that specific thing. And you can mess with the settings here. Usually, I would just leave the settings alone. I think for my case, though, I believe there's auto-blinking, so I'm going to disable that. That's the least that I want, but otherwise... Yeah, pretty much you can just click on this and you could be teleported to settings that you want. You can set up a new motion capture, again, if you want a different solution. Otherwise, you can remove the motion capture, so it really depends on you, basically. So, yeah. Either way, the next thing that we're going to do, pretty much, is we're going to go into expressions. Expressions here, I'm going to go ahead and remove my key binding just to show you. But pretty much here, you can import your VRM expressions. So if you don't see your expressions here, click on Import VRM Expressions, and it will allow you to put your expression toggles here. So you can set them up as hotkeys. If there are some extra blend shapes that you don't want to become hotkeys, then go ahead and delete whichever ones you wish not to become hotkeys, basically. So these, for instance, I do not want them as hotkeys. But again, you know, you remove it, you can adjust all the settings here, basically. Like, you can enable eye blink tracking or disable it. Or again, mouth, brow, you can adjust how you want. And you can even set up constrained blend shapes and all that. The advanced settings, I don't mess with these too much, but again, it really depends on what your preference is. Usually beginners don't really touch them, but as you get more advanced, you may want some more specific settings, so it really depends on you. But constrain, or target, whichever, basically. But you can mess with the settings however you like. So yeah, but either way, though, and also a little fun fact, by the way, Just a quick little fun fact before I show the key binding thing. In case you're wondering, what is the layers, by the way? The layers thing here, this one's actually important. So have you ever went to VC Face, right? Where you want it where if you press a hotkey, let's say I press the number one hotkey on the numpad, I press a joy face. And then if I press the number two button on the numpad, it goes into an angry blend shape rather than mixing those blend shapes. Basically, non-additive blend shapes. In case you're wondering how to do that for Warudo, you have to make sure that the blend shapes have the same layer. So whichever blend shapes are the same layer, you can have it where they don't mix into each other, but if they're in different layers, then they can mix into each other. So just wanted to at least quickly elaborate that in case you're curious. Again, I for like my joy, angry, fun, surprise face, or those sort of expressions, I always have the layer at zero, but all the other expressions, I have them as different layers, basically, so they're additive. Just wanted to at least elaborate that. But otherwise though, again, you know, mess with the things however you like, basically. So yeah. Also, I will say too, by the way, in case I will say this too, because I just realized this right now. When you set up your VRM file, in like Unity, right, and you set up all your blend shape stuff, this thing here, this is actually the ones that get translated from the VRM blend shape clips, my bad. So you don't have to touch these settings though, but if you do want to do some fine tuning, you may. But otherwise, whatever you put in Unity with the blend shape clips, they do get registered here, basically. So yeah, pretty advanced stuff that Warudo does. But either way, you can click on generate key binding blueprint right here to generate your hotkeys, basically. So you can click on that, click here, and then pretty much you can of course go to your blueprints here, go to your key binding, and then for each and every blueprint, which is basically just these two nodes, you can go through and set up manually how you want your hotkeys to be. So keystroke will be like, what button are you going to be pressing? Is it the letter, is the letters, is it the numbers on the top of your keyboard, or is it going to be from your numpad? You can also set it up where it can work on your Stream Deck too, because Warudo does have native Stream Deck support. But either way though, let's say I want numpad 1, and you can have it where you can have all these as no, and then you can do this basically, so it can be set to toggle, pretty much. And again, if by any chance you have some weird blinking issues, then of course you can go back to the blend shape settings here and disable blend shape. There are, again, more stuff you can do with Warudo, but I cannot explain it all at once. There's a lot of tiny details. It's like explaining how you use Unity, but it's node-based. So yeah, but either way, you can do this, and if I press the number 1, it won't work, but if I do control numpad, it will work. So pretty much it's adjust this thing primarily to how you want it, basically. You can also enable or disable here as well if you wish, but pretty much, you know, those are pretty much at least how you can set up your hotkeys, and you can set up for all of your other hotkeys, basically, which can be a bit tedious, basically. But after you do set it up, you will be really happy, so yeah. Anyways, though, besides that, we're going to go ahead back here. We should be done with the expressions, and then we can actually go on into animations, which will be not too long. So animations, if you want an idle animation, they have 500 plus animations here, which is really nice. You don't have to make your own. If you want to make your own, you can. Otherwise, they have a lot of different poses and animations to choose from. It's really awesome. Of course, you can just click around and choose which one that you want, basically. I'm thinking. but otherwise, if you are struggling to figure out which animation you actually want or which pose you want, you can just click on the preview gallery here, and you can choose whichever pose that you do wish for, and also some animations, basically. So yeah. Let's say, for instance, I want the one where I have this pose, so I can have this, basically. Or I could have this pose here. So yeah, I'll have this one, basically, because it looks really cute. But yeah, you can have this animation, or this pose. You can also mix and match animations, too. So if it's not the exact pose that you want, you can mix and match them. You can, again, go back to preview gallery here, choose whichever animation you prefer. Let's say I want the legs from this animation here, so I'll click on point right here. I'll zoom my character out. And then I can set this so it can mask the upper body, I think. Oh, not that one. It will mask the lower body. Whoops. Hold on a second. My bad. Let's go ahead and click that again. So I'm going to go ahead and click on point. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on mask lower body, because that's where we want the body to be at. Or at least we want the animation to affect our legs. So pretty much we can have this basically. Wah! So yeah. So you can do that to mix and match animations, which is really awesome. And then, of course, you can have the pose of your hand to be different. So I can have mine be set to a fist and then click on yes. So that way the animation is overwrite. I can set it to both. Do keep in mind, if you're going to use a mocap suit or something, you may want to have these disabled. It can be really weird, but otherwise, for like iPhone only or webcam only tracking like this, you should be fine. But mocap or full body mocap is different. You can set up to have a breathing animation, of course. So you can have it where your character is like actually breathing and such. So you can have it where you're breathing a lot and pretty much, but I usually have mine at like a lower value. You can increase the breathing rate, but try not to make it too much unless like you want it on purpose. So yeah. But either way, you can have some breathing animation. You can even have swaying animation. So if you want to have a little bit more of a realistic movement, like slight realisticness, you can of course add some movement, add some life to your character basically. So yeah. So you can do that, and of course, overlay animation transition time. So if you like toggle between animations, you can of course change the setting basically. Otherwise, you can leave it the way it is basically. So yeah. Pretty much though, what we're going to then do, we can actually apply foot IK. So if yours is no by default, then you may have some bit of a floating issue basically. But otherwise though, if you click on yes, it can help your foot stay grounded, but even then there is a setting that we can use to ensure that our foot stays in place basically. Also, there are some there's some IK issues, but don't worry, we can fix that with one of those IK settings as they are really advanced. So anyways, either way, we're gonna go into look IK. The other thing for disable unity retarget, you can just leave that as yes. You don't have to touch it. Look at IK. We can have that as enabled. This is basically where if you move your camera around, your character will look at you basically. So if you want to have that sort of like, you want to make sure your character is like looking at you basically, or looking at the chat, you can do that. You can increase the weight like this, like that. And it's like moving. Wah! So it's really nice, again, if you want to add like more life to your character, basically. Really nice. Wah! But just as you wish, though, with the settings, basically. So yeah. And then, of course, body IK. So like I said, with my whole weird leg issue, this is where we can be able to fix it. So for my case, for my legs, right? If my legs are being a little derp, I can click on left foot. For instance, I can click on create temporary IK retarget or IK target anchor, and then I can have it where now you can see that my other leg is actually doing good now, but the other one is not good because I didn't add the IK basically. So I can click right here, add another temporary IK, and that way I have much more better, you know, leg positioning basically. So now my legs actually stay in place. You can also do the same thing as well with your arms. Like let's say if you're having a lying down pose and you want your hands to like actually react, like, or just stay in place, then I can click on this one and I can have it like this. Ah! So you can have it where your hand stays in place basically. It's good for like certain posing and such basically. But yeah, pretty much there you go. Ah! And I could do the same thing with my other hand, basically. So, click on this one, it's like, ah, my hands! Ah! So, yeah. But I'll go ahead and remove the temporary IK, though. But you can, of course, add an IK target to be something else. Like, if I want it to be, like, let's say, I guess, to a table. So, let's say, like, in my environment, I have a table and I want my hands to stay on the table, then I can set it to be on the table and I can like increase the position weight and such, so that way my hands are always staying on the table. But if the table moves, then my hand just stays there basically. So you can do that sort of thing and such. Basically mess with the thing. So, but at least if you're wondering how you can fix your legs, this is how you do it. Wah! So yeah. So after that, pretty much. Then you got ragdoll settings. This is usually if you want to have like a ragdoll redeem for your streams, basically, pretty much. I right now do not know how to set this up as a redeem for Twitch or something, but you can set up a ragdoll in case you do know how to do and such. You can mess with the settings, edit ragdoll. So like if you get hit by a truck or hit by objects, you can be like yeet. So yeah. And then of course meshes, if you want to toggle meshes, like let's say you have different outfits and such. This is definitely really useful if you want to have it all mesh based instead of material blend shape. So yeah. But overall, pretty much that is pretty much all of the settings here in character. There's so much more you could do with Warudo, of course. But of course, I can't cover every little setting all at once, nor do I want to, like, overwhelm you with too many things, basically. So, yeah. But pretty much, though, at least it should hopefully help you out on at least getting started regarding, like, getting started with, like, at least the whole tracking, basically. So, yeah. And again, once you mess around with the settings a lot more, you can be able to get some really, really awesome tracking. So, yeah. Wah! But either way, though, I hope you have a lovely day. If you have any other questions regarding Warudo, if you need more assistance on getting started, though, then you can definitely check out the Warudo Discord server. It will definitely help you out on getting started with Warudo and such, or if you need, if you want to report a bug on the program or something, or if you want to request a feature, highly recommend joining the Warudo Discord server. It is definitely worth it. But otherwise, if you do have questions or if you have a tutorial request from me regarding Warudo tutorials I should make, then please let me know, though. But otherwise, though, join the Warudo Discord server if you need some help, though. But otherwise, though, I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye!